Hello, welcome to the Make Shop Show. My name is Matthew.
And I'm Ethan, and today we're going to build a hovercraft.
So, the first step is what?
We're going to need to get a pencil and the string, and then we're going to need to find the center.
And then put a finger on the string.
And then...
Alright, so we use the string and the pencil to make a circle all the way around. What's the next step?
We're going to need to go get our jigsaw and cut out that circle.
Alright.
There we go.
Yeah, that should work pretty well. So
one person's going to have to steady it.
Yep, and the other one can cut it.
Probably should sand down these edges.
Yeah, sounds good.
Now we're gonna cut a smaller circle to keep in the air. So, which piece do you think we should use?
I don't know. Biggest corner?
Yeah, we should probably do it here.
Okay, so that looks like the biggest corner. So why don't you put it down here and we'll measure the next circle. Okay, Ethan, are there any more cuts we need to make?
Yeah, we need to make a circle in the middle of the big one so we can put the leaf blower in. Probably.
All right, so where do we want to put it?
Probably put it in between the outside and the middle.
So maybe halfway between the center and the edge?
Yeah.
Okay. So maybe about here, huh? You want to mark an X there? All right, so to make the hole the right size, we'll put the leaf blower down, and then you can use the pencil and draw around the outside, okay?
Yep. First, we're gonna get a drill bit and then put a hole on the outside of the hole so we can fit the jigsaw in.
Okay. Right. Wanna crank that down? Not too far in. Safety first, so let's put our glasses on.
There?
Yep, looks good. Yeah. All right, keep going and we'll pull it out. Now that we've drilled a hole,
we're gonna put the jigsaw blade in that hole.
Okay. All right, you wanna hold it down for me?
Yep.
All right, so now we'll cut out the big hole for the blower.
So we're gonna check to see if the leaf blower fits, and
how does that work?
Looks pretty snug.
Pretty snug? Is that gonna work?
If we need extra stuff, like if we need a bigger leaf blower, we can just put some more duct tape on it.
Duct tape and cardboard?
Yep. So now we're going to sand the edges.
Okay. You can use some blocks if you want to make the sanding easier to do. You can just wrap the sandpaper around the block like that. Sometimes it's easier on your hands. And why do we want to sand these?
So it isn't, so if you hit someone, they won't get a splinter.
Okay.
I think we hit this part, so.
Yeah, are we pretty much done?
Yep. So now we're going to need to cut out the shower curtain. We're gonna need a little bit of extra material.
Around the outside edge, right?
Yeah.
Because this is gonna wrap up and around?
Yep.
Okay, so we need to cut the plastic a couple inches wider than the circle?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So it's always a good idea to leave extra material, right?
Yeah.
When we're cutting it here. It's always it's easier to trim it down later than to go back, right?
Uh-huh.
Okay. So
So now we're going to staple down our cardboard at the edge so it won't have any air get through the through an escape, so it hovers.
Okay, so we're folding the edge of the plastic around the board.
Yep.
And we're gonna use staples and pieces of cardboard to hold it down, right?
Yep.
Okay, so fold it over, hold it somewhat tight. We cut some pieces of cardboard about 1.5 inches by 4 inches. So we'll put it down here. Hold it down. All right, how about a couple more? So now we should go and check and make sure all the pieces are down flat, right?
So now we're gonna cut off the extra shower curtain that is hanging over the edge. This is the body of the hovercraft, so now we need to drill on the small circle at the bottom.
Okay. You want to be careful with the edges so you don't break the plastic, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now we're going to make sure the screws are long enough by putting them up against the edge with the small circle and see if they're long enough to go through.
All right, you want to lean down and take a look? How does it look?
That looks just about right. So we're going to need to put a patch of duct tape in the center where you're going to put your medallion.
And why do we need that?
So it doesn't cushion up and it doesn't break around the medallion.
Okay, because the plastic might get torn around the center,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
All right, so we just need to make sure there's enough duct tape on the plastic to cover the medallion. Okay, so we want to pull the string tight, hold it tight on one end, and hold it all the way across. Okay, so then put your finger here where it's at the edge.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Oh, so right at the edge here. So grab onto the string there. And then, so hang on to that and bring it over to this edge. Okay, you're okay. You just got to hang on to that one. Yeah. All right, so when both halves are exactly equal, then we know that's the center.
Yep, so about there?
There, okay.
The
so hold your finger there, medallion right there. All right, so why does this medallion have to be in the center?
The reason it has to be in the center is because if it's off balance, it will tilt in a different direction and it won't go straight.
Okay.
So yeah, this is upside down right now.
So this is the bottom, right?
When
we're riding it, this will be upside down.
Yep.
Okay.
So the medallion's only purpose is to keep it level and steering, and so the bubble can be a little bit more powerful.
Okay, so we're gonna make a little bubble with the shower curtain on the bottom.
Yeah, so this is gonna poof up about this much and then it will hover a little bit.
Okay, and so the medallion makes it sort of a ring shape, right? Like a donut? So we're gonna let some air out in the center here, right?
Yeah.
This is the bottom, so the air will come out the bottom. And then there's sort of this pillow or a donut here, right?
Uh-huh.
And then the air will come out and make our little cushion of air.
Yeah.
Perfect. Okay, so we want to make some holes. Why do we need duct tape?
So it just doesn't rip. The air doesn't rip. And, like, the air doesn't rip the shower curtain.
Okay, so the curtain's kind of weak by itself if we cut a hole in it, but if we put tape over it, it's strong.
Yeah.
So you're cutting a little triangle, right?
Yep. Okay. Doesn't really matter what shape you cut, but
it's pretty easy to cut a triangle.
The hole should be about maybe 1.5 inches big, like bigger than like over square.
It's not really tiny, but maybe 1.5 inches.
Uh-huh. So we're done with the hovercraft, and all we need to do now is test it.
Okay.
Can you flip this upside down?
Okay.
So
since this is the bottom, we're going to flip it right side up with the medallion facing downwards.
Mm-hmm. So we took off our long end on the leaf blower and we padded it with duct tape. You can always add more. You can always take it off. Perfect.
That should be pretty good, I think.
Yep.
Okay.
So, and sometimes if you have one, you should probably use a battery-powered leaf blower instead of a wired one, but they both work fine. Just the battery-powered one works. It's a little easier to use.
Don't need a cord, right?
Yep.